I have been called racist for disliking the superstitious totalitarian theocracy that is Islam, and for not joining in on the witch hunt of white racists. I also get accused of being a white supremacist, often by whites who think their people have a duty to look after those unfortunate wretches who haven't had the advantage of being born white. This is all nonsense. What I am is an English nationalist and a self-respecting white. I don't regard being born white as something to be ashamed of or something to apologize for. The same goes for being English. It isn't something that anybody should attempt to dine out on. It isn't an achievement. My ancestors were all white because so were almost all the people they ever met. Being white is not a moral badge of honor, an achievement, or a choice, but neither is it anything to be ashamed of. Anybody who attempts to manipulate me into feeling guilty for something I haven't done is not a good person, and they do not wish me well, and I see no reason why I, in turn, should respect them or their motives. I am not an evil sinner. I am not guilty of the imaginary sins of the imaginary Adam. I did not ask for anybody to be tortured to death to atone for my sins, least of all a supposedly faultless avatar of the imaginary Godhead. I reject the notion that to be human is to be a sinner needing redemption. Likewise, I reject the notion that being born white, European, or English makes me guilty of something that I didn't do. Anybody who tries to make me feel guilty for something I could not have done is up to no good and deserves to be called a manipulative shit. If anybody calls you a racist, the chances are that they are trying to pull a fast one on you. They don't think that you are a racist because calling somebody who is a racist is as productive as calling Fidel Castro a communist or Prince Charles a monarchist. It isn't a label which smarts. It is the same thing with the label of Jew. Rabbi Goldstein, you're a Jew! Is hardly going to be met with strenuous and affronted denials. But if you say Hitler's grandfather was Jewish in the wrong place, you might find yourself debating with broken glasses and pool cues. It is because they know that I am not happy to be thought of as a racist that they accuse me of it. I am not happy to be called a racist because I'm not. I don't hate anybody because of their race, and I don't regard race as being supremely important. It is madness to call anybody who accepts the existence of races a racist. You might as well call everybody who accepts the existence of sexes a sexist. If your definition of racist includes me, your definition is wrong. But I think all self-respecting whites should reject the label of racist altogether. It has ceased to have any useful agreed definition. Many leftists claim that everybody is racist. So what are we supposed to do? Agree that we are? That is like confessing to being a witch. It might stop the torture for a few moments while they gloat about it, but it won't stop them persecuting you to death. I agree entirely with Enoch Powell's answer to the question put in by David Frost as to whether he was a racialist. It depends on how you define the word racialist. If you mean being conscious of the differences between men and nations, and from that, races, then we are all racialists. However, if you mean a man who despises a human being because he belongs to another race, or a man who believes that one race is inherently superior to another, then the answer is emphatically no. I did not enslave anybody or steal their country away from them, and as a result, there is no reason why I should meekly allow my country to be stolen away from me and my people. There is no reason why I should meekly agree to be called a racist just because I see through the attempts to make me feel guilt for something that I didn't do and could not have done. Racism is stupid, the term and the concept. I am open to the idea that there are differences between human groups, which are more than skin deep. Open to it, not wedded to it. I am prepared to believe that a city with 10,000 blacks in it may have a slightly different character to one with just 3 dozen blacks, or Jews, or Chinese, whatever. The alternative, believing that race could not possibly be relevant in any way, I regard as a faith stance, totally devoid of any supporting evidence, either statistical or anecdotal. There is a big difference between believing in the possibility of something that other people refuse to countenance and accepting every possible ramification of that idea. I believe that there could be life on other planets. I don't think there is anything unique about Earth. But that doesn't mean that I believe grey aliens travel 12 parsecs to probe people's rectums in the night. I am open to the possibility that knowing something about the race of a group of people may help make predictions about their behavior as a large group. That doesn't mean that I judge individual people by their race as if that is the single most important fact that could ever be known about any individual. That's not just racist. It's stupid.